every year they add something to it. The same thing with research. You can't hand kids old books. You can hand them books and let them compare, but you can't base their curricula on old stuff. They know you're not up to speed. They're sitting looking at you like something's wrong with you. So no, I'm saying this, I gotta say it. We gotta make some changes. We gotta line up and see who's going. Who's gonna work. And it just happens sometimes to sisters. Just happens. Because I noticed in our community that folk could come to places like this, collect your money, and come back 4 or 5 years in a row and nothing built. Nothing. Nothing comes out of it but a paycheck for them. And a, what's that word, warrior scholar stuff. You know, doctor this and doctor that. And they making that doctor up. We have PhDs. We can show you ours. We can take you back to Howard and have black folk respect us or other schools we went to. All this making up stuff is our problem. We are going with the people who are working. That's what I would point. I would say that. Whoever is working, that's who we're going with. And we're coming to see that young people are getting up to speed. Some of our elders are getting up to speed. And sisters are getting up to speed. And some of brothers are picking it up. That's what we're coming to see. And I'll say that and I'll close that part of it. That it really doesn't matter to me who's on that front line. I want to know that they know how to aim at something and make sure they get it closed, the deal closed. If we got a project of books or something, a school to be set up, a homeless shelter to be set up to produce homes out of that, food co-ops, whatever it is, I want to find out who's the most skilled in that area, and we want to work out what the principles are for building that thing and then get to it. And then we're measuring people on what they did. And so if it just so happens that the room is full of men, those are the ones who did the work. If it happens that it's full of women, those are the ones who did the work. That's who I'm going with. That's who we've been working with. If it's equal across the board with who's doing work, men and women, that's what the meeting should look like. But what we got going on is trying to mix something from the past that may not have that may not reflect all of what's happening now. You know, some of it is right, and I'll say this openly. We've been shattered. Our culture and civilization has been shattered. Islam, Christianity, Judaism, folk bringing stuff into Africa, anything that came into Africa as their ideology was destructive to Africa. Because there's nothing that the Arabs brought into Africa that was more advanced than Kemet. They came in as desert nomads. They couldn't even read and write. You show me something they wrote in the 6th century AD. Show me anything. Kemet was writing 4,000 years before that. We have the documentation of it. It's in our book. So when we talk about something, we talk about documentation, evidence. So somebody comes into your society, defeats you, takes it over, selling tickets to you so you go and look at the monuments that we built, making it look like they built it, and then you aren't in any religion that they made up. Same thing with the Romans and Christianity. Came in, defeated us, after the Persians defeated us, after the Assyrians defeated us, and after the Greeks defeated us. Romans were last on that tip. And then imposed their ideology on us, and some of us are still with it. So I say all that to say, we're gonna have to clean some things up. You know, we gotta look at things and openly say, well, maybe that ain't working. Let's see what's working. And I know one thing that works. Whoever does the work should be respected for it, should be given the merits of it. If you can fly that plane and you're a woman, I don't want a brother on there if he don't know how to fly. I don't want him in the cockpit until he goes through the training necessary to fly that plane. I want to live. If a school needs to be built and a sister has gone through all the necessary preparation to run that school and build it? Bethune-Cookman? I'm going with the system. So I'm saying we got to work that out. But in the final analysis, if we go together, we won't have this battle. We'd be right beside each other. Eve and I, right beside each other, walking down this path. And so I say all that to say, Yara has been in this the whole time. I met him at a one of these white institutions, Central Michigan University. I just gotten out of Howard. He was there. He was in the Marines, a soldier. I had to get him out of it. I had to get him out of there, but I didn't want him to get rid of the training he got. But the ideology that was being imposed on him, that he should be some lapdog running around trying to kill somebody for someone else. You ain't getting nothing out of that. How do you justify that? On your way out, you done murder up some people for somebody else. You can't justify it. Can't live with yourself. I know I couldn't. Put your gun down. You know, aiming at the people you should be aiming at. So I say all that to say, you know, these questions are being asked, and the one about the young man asking about you doing the right thing, what can we do? Well, that's part of what we're doing here. You have to start off with young people. You know, we're older. I'm in my 50s. I'm tired. I've been working the whole time, but I'm going to keep going, but I'm tired. You should be bringing folk up the rear, as we're doing, young people, putting them in key positions, training them, and then letting them go. Not being a person who's watching over them, telling them what to do. Once you get them out there, once they're ready to go, you let them go, because they're going to go farther than you. They're going to go faster, too. You don't see Michael Jordan out there on the court trying to, you know, he ain't going to be able to do nothing with this group of guys. He's too old. And that's probably what we missed in some respects, that we should respectfully learn how to hand torches over. Train the youth. Make sure they respect us, but train them and prepare them. So yeah, that whole system we begin to implement in our books. We set up study teams. And from those study teams, we begin to see who is serious about understanding the problems that we have. Because you can't solve something if you don't know what it is. So you got the first study. Once you study something, you can't be just studying stuff. You can't run around studying. You need to sum up your research. And so we wrote a book called SEBA. That's a research handbook. You move from researching to doing. Action. Most people get trapped on that talking. You know, reading and talking. What are you going to do? We don't have food in our neighborhood. So what we need to do is set up some way to do our own farming. Set up our own grocery store that comes from the farm. That ain't just talking. Somebody got to get to work on the principles of that and get it built. I say form committees, which we do. See who has the skill in that area, invite the people in town. You know, extract what you can extract from them and get the people to work who can work in that area. You know, setting up black businesses. You got to find people who know how to set them up and make them move forward. Same thing with publishing. Same thing with schools. Homeschool. Committees. That's what we're talking about. That's what we're going around organizing. And so I say in the final analysis, young people should be started at the earliest. If you can get them when they're 1, 2, 3, and 4 and start working on them, you got something. It's hard to deal with something that gets hardened. You know cement. It's hard to deal with cement. You want it when it's still wet. You move it around. But it's hard to deal with brothers and sisters when they hit their 30s and 40s and 50s and 60s. Like, it's hard to do something with it. So I say all to say that that's being done. And obviously hand you some handouts. You got 6. And we're going to go over those, and I hope you all can stay around and really get it, because I'll meticulously go over those and let you know that everything we did, we planned it. And we planned it and worked our plan. 2.5 years to print those books, for 25 years preparing for them. You know, so if we had done it another way, it would have taken us 50 years to do these books. If you try to do a book a year, a book every 2 or 3 years, you know, research and then write a book, you will be dead before you got through 5 or 6. I mean, big ones. That's why you don't see these around nowhere. You don't see books like this around. Because the people have to be disciplined enough to take 20 or 30 years of reading hundreds of books and summing them up in journals, like Ife did.